Hello Techies. In this tutorial, we will learn a new update as part of December 2021 release, that is Power Automate for Desktop Recorder. Power Automate Desktop had two recorders earlier. One is Web Recorder, second one Desktop Recorder. As part of December 2021 release, the Web Recorder and the Desktop Recorder are unified into a single Power Automate for Desktop Recorder. With the unified recorder, users can record both their web and desktop related activities during a single recording session. If you observe, I have created a desktop flow with the name of December 2021 updates. There, if you observe on the topmost, previously, before December 2021, we had two recorders. One is Web Recorder, another one Desktop Recorder. But in the December 2021 release, these two recorders have been unified as a single recording session. There you can see I'm having only single recorder over here. If you mouse over on that, you will find it capture the steps of your automation to be converted into flow actions. All right. By using this recorder, we can record our both web and desktop related activities during the single recording session. All right, I will show you a small example for the unified recorder by using this recorder over here. I'm going to open a browser over here, and then I'm going to use http://employee-registration. This is the same registration form which I used for the web recording in our previous sessions. Once I have launched this browser, and then I'm going to use the URL localhost/employee-registration.html. I need to provide the details over here. In such a way, I'm going to give the name of the employee as Basha. Employee number, I'm going to give it as 123456. And I'm going to give the gender as male. And I'm going to give the departments as IT and medical. And the address, I'm going to give it as Bangalore. Contact number, I'm going to give it as 10 9s over here, and then I'm going to give the job location over here as Bangalore. Designation, I'm going to give it as technology analyst, and the email ID, I will provide it as basha@gmail.com. This is the manual flow which we are going to do for the employee registration form. Once we are going to click on submit, the registration has done successfully. Now the same kind of thing I need to do by using unified desktop recorder. All right, how can we go ahead and do that? There, if you see, I'm having the recorder. Let's click on the recorder. In this session, as a first step, I'm going to show you the web recording way. But we don't have any separate recorders over here like web recorder or desktop recorder. Now, over here, if you observe, I'm having three dots over here that is representing more actions. Whenever you're going to launch a browser, there you can see launch a new browser, and then based on your requirement, you want to open Microsoft Edge, Chrome, Firefox, or Internet Explorer. Based on that, you are going ahead and then you are going to click the particular browser. I'm going to select Chrome over here, and then I'm going to give the respective URL over here in the blank session. I'm going to give it localhost/employee-registration, right? I'm going to copy the same URL over here, and then I'm going to paste it in the above blank. There you can see launch Chrome and navigate to. I'm going to modify it as http://employee-registration.html. All right, now this is about the browser which I'm going to do. Let's check it out if it is working or not. Now the browser, I'm going to use it as Chrome so that I'm going to make it maximize. I'm going to select the properties of the launch new Chrome, and then the window status, I'm going to make it as maximize. All right, let's click on save. And now let's go ahead, let's run the flow to see the output. Now, if you observe, https://localhost/employee-registration.html has opened in the new Chrome window, and then the window status maximize, right? From here, I need to record the steps step by step by using this recorder. Let's click on recorder, and then I'm going to start recording for the web applications. All right, let's click on record, And now I'm going to select each and every activity over here. Now if you observe, whenever I'm going to select the areas of the employee name or the particular employee number, in that case, you will find these values, input text, select that. And I'm going to give it as Amir Basha. And then I have given the input over here, right? Now, if you observe on the right hand side, I got the populated text field in the web page, that is input 13 with the on-screen recording with so-and-so thing. And you can see the input value as Amir Basha, right? Now, the second value, I'm going to give it over here as employee number. There you can see, I'm getting a red mark over here with the input text. So that I'm going to give the input text over here as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is the second value, right? There you can see, if you observe the populate text field in web page, that is input 14, and the recording with the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the gender I have selected, and then the departments. Over here, if you see, I'm going to select the departments over here as IT, another one medical. Now for every activity, you will find the values over here, or the actions over here, you will find in the recorder panel. Now, the address, I'm going to give it as Bangalore. And after that, I'm going to give the contact number over here. The input text over here for the contact number, I'm going to give 10 digits with 999. And after that, the job location. There, if you observe, the job location is the drop-down, right? There you can see I'm having Bangalore. And the designation, I'm going to select as single value. There also, I'm going to select the value as senior software. And the final one, I have to give the input over here as email ID. I'm going to give it as basha@gmail.com. These are the repetitive steps which I need to give it for every registration form, right? And once I have given all the details, I'm going to click on submit. Submit is the button which we have in the registration form. All right, let's click on submit. Now you can see, thank you for the registration. And if you observe, all the flows actions have been recorded by using the recorder for the web application. All right, now let's click on finish. Now, once you click on finish, all the sequence of steps has been recorded and the action has been displayed in the desktop flow. There you can see the first step is that launch new Chrome with the maximizer window, and then you can see populate text field, and after that to provide the values, input values as Amir Basha 1 2 3 4 5 6, and the inputs you can see the radio button as mail and the respective checkbox, right, in the such a way IT department or medical department, and then you can find the different values over here. All right, now let me save the flow by clicking on Control S, or you can click on save option over here. Now let's run the flow to see the output by clicking on run. Flow execution started. There you can see a window has been launched with the localhost slash employee registration.html. There you can see every values has been given over here. There you can see Amir Basha, employee number 1 2 3 4 5 6, mail, and after that Bangalore. There you can see the designation, email ID, and then it has been submitted successfully. All right. I hope you understand how to record our web application flow actions by using Unified Recorder. All right. Now, I will show you how to record desktop related activities by using Recorder. Over here, I will show you a small example by using calculator. Okay, what we have to do, I need to add two numbers or subtract two numbers by using calculator. How can I go ahead and record the sequence of steps by using recorder for the desktop application? All right, let me record the sequence of steps by using recorder for the desktop application. Let's click on recorder to record desktop related activities. All right, now to record our desktop related activities, I'm directly going to use record option, that is start recording. Let's click on that. And from there onwards, I'm going to record each and activity which I'm going to do on the desktop. Let's click on start. and then I'm going for the run command. There I'm going to give it as Calci, and then I'm going to click on OK. And then I'm going to record each and every step in the calculator. That is, I'm going to add two numbers, that is button, that is 2. I'm going to add plus, and then I'm going to give another value as 5. And then I'm going to sum, that is equal to 7. This is my output, all right? These are all the sequence of steps which are related to the desktop application. All right, once it has been done, I'm going to click on finish from the recorder. Now, if you observe, all the desktop application related actions have been loaded successfully by using recorder. All right, I hope you understand how to use the unified recorder to record both web and desktop related activities as part of this tutorial. Thank you for watching Power Automate tutorials. If you have any queries related to this concept, please post them in the comment section. I will see you in the next session. Till then, bye-bye. Have a wonderful day.